Crimean Tatars in Ukraine's capital Kiev held a candlelight vigil marking 70 years since the mass deportation of Tatars from the Crimean Peninsula under orders from the Soviet Union's Joseph Stalin. The actual anniversary is Sunday, but participants say this year's remembrance comes at a worrying time for the community. CCTV's Roy Ruttenberg has more from Kiev.
The candles had been laid out ahead of time, lined up to form a map of Crimea, the Tatar symbol, and in red, the number 70 and the words, "No genocide." The Crimean Tatar leader in exile attended the ceremony. He offered harsh words for Russia, which banned him from returning to the peninsula for the next 5 years.
This is a country using its force to occupy another one in the 21st century, and we hope that the international community and the Ukrainian people united will help end this lawlessness.
After Russia's annexation of Crimea, this year's ceremony held extra significance for many Tatars.
We are holding this ceremony here, but it's sad and painful because we'd rather go back there.
Many of those who lit a candle here were non-Tatar Ukrainians. Some said, in hindsight, they wish they could have done more.
During the last 20-something years, Crimean Tatars were actually the only pro-Ukrainian force in Crimea. They were supporting Ukraine, and yet we weren't able to protect them as we should have.
It's a loyalty prominently on display. The candles here were lit to remember the past, but they also shine a light on what many fear is a dark future. Organizers say they'll participate in a march here in Kiev on Sunday in solidarity with those in Crimea who can't. Roy Ruttenberg, CCTV in Kiev.